Subscribe to our YouTube channel and click on the bell icon for latest updates.
Hello students, welcome to the session on preparation tips for the SBI Bank PO entrance examination, and particularly how to prepare for this entrance examination during the lockdown period. So this question is there in the minds of lakhs of people who are looking towards their dream destination, and that's State Bank of India, and working there. So how to go about the preparation during the lockdown? That question haunts a lot of people these days. But my friends, the most important thing is that you have a lot of time these days. It is like a blessing in disguise. People are locked down at home, which means what? You have enough time to prepare, and a lot of hours to study. So focus, concentrate, and work hard in the right direction. That should be the key for this very competitive examination. And that's a known fact. Lakhs of people appear for this examination. People who are serious, they get through it. So that's the whole thing. So if you look at, in the last few years, we've seen a lot of banking jobs. And if you look at the banking sector index, it has grown at a compounded annual rate of around 51%. And since 2001, in fact, in the last 20 years, it has grown a lot. So in the next few years, we will definitely see a lot of recruitments happening in this whole sector, banking sector, be it SBI, be it RRBs, be it IBPS or other, banks. So students, aspirants, gear up for the preparation. That's what I would like to advise you. One. Second, see, when you look at the banks today, it is not the same, job which people used to do earlier. Now, a lot of new products and services comes into the gamut of banking. It's not just loans for that matter. It's a lot of other things. So it is about, say, wealth management, or maybe life and general insurance, investment banking, mutual funds, a lot of things to be done in the banks. So banking sector opens up a lot of avenues for a lot of students. So it's not about just limiting yourself to one particular specific job. So future definitely is great, right? So that's how the banking sector looks like now, if you look at the future. So now comes how to prepare for the entrance examination. Notifications are not yet out. Exam keeps on, moving ahead. I mean, if you look at the dates, the exams have been postponed, but then that's fine. Sooner or later, you'll see this examination in a couple of months. So please start working on it. That's what it is. Utilize your time in the lockdown. So you can easily utilize it by keeping yourself busy, because today a lot of people complain that they don't have, things to do. They're free. And if you're free, so please engage yourself, improving your aptitude. English, reasoning, maths, computers, GK, all these things which come in the examination. So you have to be very careful about, time management. Prioritize the most important tasks to be done first, and then the less important, and then the least important. So prioritization is another important thing. So one has to properly divide time for each area, whatever comes in the examination. And once you divide time for each area, it should not be that you do just one area the whole day. No, you'll get bored. Also, you should not do it, at a stretch of, say, 4 hours, 5 hours. No. So mix it well. Say maybe 2 hours mathematics, 2 hours reasoning, maybe 2 hours English. And then enough breaks in between. Say half an hour break or 1 hour break in between. Spend some time, working on your mind, working on your body as well. So breaks should also be taken while studying to overcome the monotony. So that's an important thing. Have a daily and weekly goals. To work on these areas, have a daily goal. Just don't depend on the number of hours. That'll be, not a very right approach. You should have specific chapters on your mind. That, okay, I'll complete this chapter today. I'll do these many questions today. So that kind of daily and weekly goals should be set up, rather than sitting with the books for 12 hours and getting nothing out of it, mind you, my friends. So that's again a real problem with students. Another issue in the lockdown is to keep yourself motivated. If you see around, you may see gloom everywhere. If you see news, which is very important for you, GK, current affairs comes in your examination. If you see news for say 1 hour, you get depressed. So you need to keep yourself motivated. Read online magazines, read online newspapers, and a bit of news on TV. That's how it should be. Rather than spending 2 hours on TV and reading half an hour of online newspaper, no. Online newspapers and magazines should be given more time. So that's how it should be, right? So that's again a big challenge during the lockdown, how to keep yourself motivated. So feel positive, think positive. You have enough time, go get your dream. The SBI, the dream, you know, destination for a lot of students. So when I talk of the exam particularly, they hold the exams in different stages, the preliminary, the mains, and later on the interview. So that's how the examination is conducted. In the preliminary examination, if you look at, they focus on three areas: English, quantitative, and reasoning. That's what the focus is, three areas. And then comes the main examination, where you have more sections. There the focus is on reasoning, computer aptitude, data analysis and interpretation, GK, English, and descriptive writing. So a lot of sections in the mains exam. It is not just about clearing the preliminary examination. A lot of people, what they believe is that first of all, let me clear the prelim and then I'll prepare for mains. No, that's not the very right approach. Between the preliminary exam and the mains exams, you don't have a lot of time. So please have that, you know, far-sightedness kind of thing. You know, look at future, that okay, once I clear the prelim, I need to work on computer knowledge, general awareness, and descriptive writing, which cannot be done in say 15 days or 1 month. So start working on all the areas from the very beginning, my friend. That's very, very crucial. So keep this tip in your mind. It is about working on all the areas rather than only the preliminary sections. So be careful about it. Don't do this mistake of ignoring the mains examination. So be positive, I said. So the preparation for prelim and mains should be done together, thinking that you will crack the prelim exam. So optimism is the key over here, right? So I'm sure in this lockdown there is no dearth of time. You can easily spend 6 to 8 hours every day on studies. And a lot of times reading news and GK is fun. Reading English, you know, articles and reading comprehension passages, it's fun, which it is. So you can focus on that as well. So you get around 100 questions in 1 hour in the preliminary examination. So 100 questions to be done in 1 hour. And you have sectional time limits. So you need to work on speed as well. So take a lot of mock tests, timed tests, so that you know that in 20 minutes, how many questions can you do? So 20 minutes for English, 20 minutes for quant, 20 minutes for reasoning. So timed tests should be taken regularly. That's very important. Same situation is in the mains also. There you have a lot of four sections. You have four sections, but then all of them are timed. Reasoning and computers, they are the most important section. Why do I say that? Because you get around, 45 questions in that. So 45 questions to be done in 60 minutes. So the maximum questions come from reasoning and computer aptitude. Focus on that. And also on data interpretation and analysis. So these two areas should be focused more. And then comes English and GK. So general awareness is more of economics and banking awareness. So, know all the basic definitions of bank, know about the economies of the world, know about those terminologies and whatever is going on in the last 6 to 8 months. So whatever has happened in the 6 to 8 months, you need to know that as well. And the descriptive section also should be practiced. So there's a second. Even for your interviews, you need to start working. So there is a group exercise and an interview. So you have to work on that as well. So that's again an important aspect if you wish to prepare for this examination. So coming to the particular things, English one can work on vocab building, do some para based questions like para jumble, reading comprehension passages from different areas, do these things, work on the grammar skills, know about parts of speech, clauses, phrases and all. So you need to work on that. Look at certain tips on improving vocabulary faster by going through some root methods. So depend on faster methods of improving your vocabulary. Depend on common sense for grammar. Practice reading comprehension daily. Every day at least 1 to 2 passages should be done. Every day, I'm saying, my friend. Understand the prefix and the suffix of the words. Learn, not memorize. Learn, that's very important. Read magazines, newspapers for general awareness. Depend on the GK capsules, more or less. PPT based GK, depend on that. Time provides you a lot of, PPTs on the happenings of the month. So depend on those things, basic economics, terms and all, that should also be done. So depend on that. For quant, you need to work on, different chapters like time and work, time and distance, number series, percentages, probability, geometry, mensuration, all those chapters which you did in your class 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. So that can be easily done. Nothing very new to you, you've done it already. The problem would be normally in reasoning and GK, that's what it should be. Because GK and reasoning is something which people have not done in their school days or college days. This may be something new probably. So have a plan for reasoning and GK. So do questions on coding, decoding, blood relations, symbols, critical reasoning, deductive reasoning. All cats are dogs, some rats are maths. You get a lot of questions on syllogism in the examination, puzzles. Solve these kind of special type of questions. That's very important. With this something new. And computer knowledge also should be worked upon. So overall, these are the basic things one can work upon while preparing for the bank PO examination, entrance examination in the lockdown period. So we from Time family wish you all the best. Thank you very much. Take care. Stay safe.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and visit Careers 360 website for more details.